Okay, we're back for another session tonight. I had a few people joining me this afternoon watching this come to life. But we've still got a fair way to go, so we'll put a bit more work into this now. If you're tuning in, please let me know what you think. If you know anyone that might be interested in watching the process of this, maybe an art collector, someone that would like to have this on their wall, share away. I will be auctioning the piece off following the demonstration. It'll be going up for auction in the next few days. So please get in contact and we'll get things going. So the top part of the head's all coming together pretty nicely at this point. We really want to start working through those fine wrinkles around the eyes, building a bit more light and variation. Just going to quickly reload my pastel palette. And then we shall get down to work. All right, let's get stuck into it. Use this dark brown grey to integrate some of the dark and the light together through here. Now, for a lot of what was done here earlier on, I actually worked without reference. I had my initial marking using my reference, but I don't like to be a complete slave to it, so I jump away from that from time to time. Only coming back when I really need to bring things together. Top of the feature is all working nicely. It's time to start getting stuck in to the jowls and the mouth next. We're going to start by lifting up the lights on the nose first. So I'm working with my rusty tone pastels. This is a piece of Colorfix paper by Art Spectrum that is my support tonight, just a terracotta base paper at about A4 size. With here, similar to a warm white. Just going to shape some of this form over the top of where the pink fleshy tone already is to pull the shapes together. If you're logging on, thanks for joining me. Riley just got started for the night session. So hopefully you enjoy. If you have questions along the way, by all means, just post them up. I'll be checking the stream regularly. My working methods are a lot of very thin layers built one over the other to create my image. I let the pastels do the work, so finger blending is out. Hi Debbie, thanks for joining. Hope you're enjoying. I'm guessing it's early morning where you are. We're at about 11 o'clock at night here. We put in probably an hour's session tonight on this before closing things down for the night. Everything you see on the paper so far has all been done live. Just working with a little bit of a soft umber at the minute. Contrast and variety through their skin tones, shaping in and around the snout. Things get quiet, don't stress. As I said, ask questions. More than happy to answer along the way. I'm actually working with my own handmade pastels. I make a range called the Rusty Tones. As you can see, this is my palette here. I find working off a pastel palette like this makes life a lot easier. This just sits on my forearm, same as a painter's palette would. And the coarseness of the foam keeps the pastels reasonably clean as well. It's quite a handy little tool. I have everything sitting on my forearm as I need to when I work. They're no longer available for purchase, so I haven't been producing for a few years now. Unfortunately, couldn't get a couple of the pigments I needed. It made up about 2/3 of my range. So my stock that I've got left over is pretty much for me from here on out. Hoping in the future I'll be able to get back into it. Considering a few years ago when Terry Ludwig was over here, he and I caught up and he actually gave my pastels a try and was pleasantly surprised by how well they work. It's starting to get fairly bright here on the board. Hopefully my camera can keep up. A lot of this will get toned down, it's just putting in a decent layer of light over the top of my midtones before I start pulling back through them with all my variations. So already we're starting to get a bit more roundness across the top of the lip here. Hey Alyssa, how you doing? Thanks for tuning in. Going to pull in this side of the face a little bit. I feel it's coming out a bit too far. That's better. It's amazing how much difference a tiny little variation can make. Perception of how you see something. nose form is starting to come together now. Quite happy with this at this stage. Build these wrinkles just a little bit more, and then we'll start running some of the whiskers through. This stage is really about just putting marks in and manipulating them. Constantly stepping back, getting different viewpoints to check and see how each mark is impacting everything else. Hi Joan, I'm actually working with my own handmade pastels. They look a little bit different to what is generally on the market. These are my rusty tones. Each one of them is handmade in the most traditional fashion possible. Essentially, I get there and mix up my pigments like a cookie dough, mixing them in an old glass Pyrex dish, and then rolling them out into individual sticks, which are then cut with a palette knife and left to dry for a week. And yeah, I learnt a long time ago to let the pastels do the work for me. So finger blending is off limits for the way that I work. I've been told the technique that I work with is a little bit unusual compared to what a lot of people do. I developed this tap technique close to 20 years ago now when I started working in pastel. Of ways, so whether it's just using the tip of the pastel like what I'm doing here to essentially stipple in against the existing marks, softening areas, manipulating other areas, we're using it for broad stroke exactly the same way. One of the reasons I came up with the size of pastel that I have here is because every stick that I ever bought, I always broke in half. At that point, it was usable to me. Up until that was done, it just seemed like a lot of excess. The other thing that I always found was the soft pastels on sanded surface, this is Colorfix I'm working on at the moment, always crumbled the moment that you did anything with them. They weren't designed to take any impact. And as you can see with the way that I work, it's all about impact. start to put in some of these whiskers. This is actually a super pale phthalo blue. I find against all of the pinks in the flesh tones, those soft browns, soft oranges, it just gives a nice crispness to the line. Working the blade of the pastel at the moment. And given that I've got so much build up through the jowl area here, the pastel slips pretty easily over the surface. Touches here and there. With some of the flesh tones, just pull it back into place. When I first started, I played around with pastel pencils, but in all honesty, I found that now that I make them, I can pretty much do everything with the stick. There's no real need to bring the pencils out. I do my initial drawing with a white charcoal pencil to get these started, but outside of that we keep it pretty clean. Depending on the paper surface that I'm working on, I might get there and do an acrylic underpainting. But generally what goes on my pastel work is literally just the pastel. Still live streaming.
Okay.
What's up?
Nothing, just mom working out.
Okay. Continuing with that question about the pastel pencils, I prefer the dynamic of the line that I'll get using a stick. Being able to taper the mark, vary it. It just has a more interesting rhythm personally. Some wildlife artists that produce incredible work using pastel pencils. But my style is more based on suggested detail rather than every single mark being where it needs to be. I'm actually going to bring just a few touches of grey through some of these in the shadows. Really starting to feel like the character's coming out now. I find sometimes they take a while to reveal themselves. Which makes it even more challenging when we're in a demonstration situation like this. Sometimes they play, sometimes they don't. No blending is the key to making sure you don't end up with mud. One thing that might not be really obvious when watching a demonstration like this is that every layer is super thin. There's not a huge amount of pastel actually going on unless I want it there. Which means I've still got control. I also find it's important to try and harmonize your colors as much as possible as well. Experiment and play. And that way you'll work out what colors will integrate well with each other. Anytime I'm working on a subject, I'm not just looking at what the actual color is, I'm looking at the other colors that are influencing it and how I can work with those to produce a richer look than what it would be if I just went straight and went, okay, I need to get a purple grey. I look at what's happening through the fur here. And I go, okay, so I've brought through my darks. I'm now about to bring through a bit of mid-tone. And this is just going to help shape the forms. Now, I've had slight purples and mauves brought in those greys behind. This layer is actually slightly green by comparison. It's more of an umber base grey. All the while, still letting touches of that paper show through. If you're watching this, you've probably found my page by now. And if that's the case, have a look at the post I put up earlier tonight where you see the step-by-steps of this piece coming to life. And you'll see the layering process. You'll see how much the paper still works for the picture. Over the top of what we've just done there, I'm now going to take a slightly blue-grey. So this is essentially just an ultramarine blue that I've greyed off. If you're watching this and you're working in animal art, maybe you've just got started and want some more guidance, in the next few weeks I am running a series of workshops looking at doing wildlife work. next Sunday, we focus on big cats, lions and tigers, cheetahs. Looking at the basics of getting started. Breaking down the animal anatomy, making it something more than just a static drawing. In 2 weeks' time, I'll be focusing on these guys and their other primate cousins. And then week three of the wildlife workshops, we'll be working on the elephant, producing a piece showcasing the African elephant. Alright, that pretty much sees us to the end of this demonstration. Just going to do a tiny little bit of cleanup through our background here. And then this piece will be signed and ready to go up for auction. Glad you found me. Hope you enjoyed it. With the workshops, I do aim to give my students as much information as possible. As much as I love painting, I love teaching. Helping others get to the next level in their journey makes it all worthwhile for me. Just going to taper back this mark a little bit. That's better. And that, folks, sees us to the end of our live demonstration for the day. Hope everyone enjoyed it. If you've got any questions, by all means, ask away. Otherwise, make sure you like and follow my page. I normally get there and do 2 to 3 live streams a week, and every Sunday we run a live workshop on Zoom for anyone that's interested. Thanks for watching.